To solve the given rational equation, we want to multiply both sides of the equation by an expression that will eliminate the fractions. This expression will be the least common denominator, or least common multiple, of the quantity x plus 6, the quantity x minus 3, and the quantity x squared plus 3x minus 18. So to determine the least common denominator, we do want to make sure the denominators are in factored form, so we'll start by factoring this. Factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of negative 18 that add to 3 are positive 6 and negative 3. This is actually good news because notice how these two factors do occur in the other two denominators. Now that our denominators are factored, we should be able to recognize that the least common denominator would be the quantity x plus 6 times the quantity x minus 3. So now instead of obtaining a common denominator, we're going to multiply each term in the equation, or both sides of the equation, by this product. So now we're going to go ahead and rewrite the original equation, leaving plenty of space horizontally. And now we'll multiply each fraction by the LCD. So we'll have times the quantity x plus 6 times the quantity x minus 3. We'll put this over 1. It's not required to do this, but it will make it easier to see what's going to simplify out. And now we'll do the same to the other two fractions. And now we'll simplify. Notice here we have a factor of x plus 6 over x plus 6, which simplifies to 1. Here we have a factor of x minus 3 over x minus 3. And here we have a factor of x plus 6 over x plus 6, and x minus 3 over x minus 3. Now we'll determine these products and then solve the resulting equation. Notice here we have the quantity x minus 3 times the quantity x minus 3 plus, here we have the quantity x minus 2 times the quantity x plus 6. And on the right side we just have x squared. Now we'll clear the parentheses. So we'll have x squared minus 3x minus 3x, that's minus 6x, plus 9, plus x squared, plus 6x minus 2x, that's plus 4x, minus 12 equals x squared. Now we'll combine like terms on the left. We have 1x squared plus 1x squared, that's 2x squared, negative 6x plus 4x, that's minus 2x, and then 9 minus 12 is negative 3, so we have minus 3 equals x squared. Now we'll set it equal to 0 by subtracting x squared on both sides. So then notice the right side would be 0, and we have x squared minus 2x minus 3. Let's go ahead and move this over here and factor this. The factors of x squared are x and x. The factors of negative 3 that add to negative 2 would be negative 3 and positive 1. This product will be equal to 0 when x is equal to 3, because that would make this factor equal to 0, or when x is equal to negative 1, because negative 1 would make this factor equal to 0. Now before we say these are the solutions, we do need to go back up to the equation just for a moment. We know division by 0 is undefined, so we must exclude the values of x that would make these denominators equal to 0. Well, notice if x was equal to negative 6, it would make this denominator equal to 0 as well as this one, so we must exclude negative 6. But notice also positive 3 would make this denominator and this denominator equal to 0, so x also cannot equal positive 3. And this does conflict with one of our solutions here where we say x equals 3. X cannot equal 3 here because it would make the denominator equal to 0, and therefore we only have one solution. We would have x equals negative 1. So it is important that we always make sure that we exclude the values that would make the denominators equal to 0 before we state our final solution. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.